It's a pleasure to be joining in this celebration of 140 years of U.S.-Romanian diplomatic relations. I only played a small part in that during the 3 years I was ambassador of the United States in Romania during the late 1990s. But I remember in particular, in addition to the friendship and support the Romanian and Romanian leaders and diplomats gave to the United States on important issues, the good advice that we got. Two particular examples come to mind. Once was when now President-elect, then U.S. Senator Joe Biden came to Romania to thank Romanian leaders for their support of NATO in stopping ethnic cleansing in Kosovo. He quizzed all the leaders about politics in Yugoslavia, about who were the leaders, how could change come about, who were the democratic forces. And he got very, very detailed advice because Romanian leaders know Serbian leaders and know the region in a way that obviously Americans can't. And so we got very, very good advice that helped lead over the next year or so, frankly, to democracy coming to Yugoslavia and Serbia, which is a big deal for them. It's a big deal for Romania, and it's a big deal for the United States. The other is more strategic in the sense that during that period of time, the United States, me included, were more optimistic than we are today about the how quickly Russia would become a democratic country. And I remember all the time, particularly then Foreign Minister Andrei Pleshu, but others who would sort of kid me and say, we're a little worried you have too much trust in these Russians. And we would say, well, we have high expectations for them. And the Romanian leaders or diplomats would say, well, we know them very well, and we're a little more pessimistic. And of course, the Romanians turned out right. Russia is not where we want it today. But America and Romania are where we want it today. We are democratic allies in NATO and working very, very well together.